Mossport proves to be a tough track for the GTs. Welcome to Mets Race News. Hello everybody and welcome to Mets Race News. Not going to call it a new era anymore because it's not really new. It's kind of the norm now. So I have two things to go over. The DTM race at Montreal and the Clean Coal Endurance Series race at Mossport. Race 3 at Mossport. Well, not race 3 at Mossport. You get what I'm saying. Let's cover the DTM race. Just going to say the winner, South O'Donoghue, was a good race. It was kind of the rumble strips and the chicanes really were a struggle for them. But just watch the race. You'll know what I'm talking about. And the Clean Coal Endurance Series, race 3 at Mossport is... We're going to go over a few things here. As I said, the prototypes, it was really good for them. And GT seemed to struggle a lot. GTs were not meant for chicanes, they're not good with chicanes, carousels, they're not good with carousels, and prototypes are just so good at that, so they began to lap them. So for prototypes, Chris Aurelio dominated the first half of the race, and the GT Dirk Muller dominated as well. And then, it was a good race, but there wasn't as much going on. So for prototypes, David Land did win for Porsche, and then for GT, Dirk Muller did win for BMW. It was a good race, don't get me wrong, Mossport's always a great track to watch, but not a lot went on. There was a few things, Kyler Boggs kind of spun out when he went into pit road, and just a few things went on. Pit strategy didn't play too much of a role in the race, as other tracks may have, and Daytona especially was a huge pit strategy race, so. It was an interesting race, I would watch it. I'm not going to put the link in the description, because I'm sure you guys know where to go at this point. Go to youtube.com/JoeDonoghue. Or just look up on YouTube, Joe Donoghue. I'm sure he's going to pop up, considering he's very popular. So, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you all next week.